So you're thinking about adding a new fuel to your slate. Well, have you thought about your options? There's more than 250 million passenger cars and trucks on the road in America, and basically, all of them need some kind of liquid fuel. So how do you choose? In the past, you probably chose from these three options. But today, the market looks different. Of those 253 million cars and light-duty trucks, 7 million take diesel. 18 million are built to use premium. And you probably know about flex fuel vehicles that take ethanol blends from E0 to E85, but you may not know that there are 20 million of those FFVs on the road today. Now, those are all pretty good numbers, but this is where it gets interesting. In just the past few years, almost 25 million cars and light trucks have been built and warrantied by the manufacturers to run on E15. When you put those two together and add the cars and trucks EPA has approved to run on E15, which is every other car or truck built since 2001, you've got a whopping 200 million cars approved to run on E15. That is 80% of the market, my friend. Even better, nearly every new gas-powered vehicle that hits the road each year is now warranted to use E15. That's like another 14 million new cars every year. With E15, you're looking at about 11 times more customers than premium and about 28.5 times more than diesel. Not only that, diesel and premium cost more than regular, so they've always been a tough sell. So now you can offer E15, a fuel that 80% of the market can use, and you can offer it for a couple of cents per gallon less than regular. Which should you choose? This or this? And if you think your customers aren't asking for flex fuels, think again. I mean, 70% of drivers say they buy fuel based on price. For flex fuels and E15, the future is bright indeed. Go to flexfuelforward.com to get the scoop. And when you're ready to move forward, flex forward.